So it is a statistical test which involves the calculation of quantity which is used to compare an observation ratio with the expected ratio or critical ratio and to determine how closely the former fits the later. Means what it is a type of chi-square is a type of statistical measures or test by which we are calculating the quantity. So here in this chi-square test we are calculating the quantity measures, and which type of quantity we have to observe certain or given certain observed ratio, and we have to compare observed ratio from the expected ratio. So today's topic is nothing but the chi-square test. So the chi-square, it helps us to find out the degree of discrepancy. Discrepancy means difference between. So it helps us to find out the degree of discrepancy between the observed ratio, observed frequency, and the expected frequency. And thus to determine whether the difference between the observed and the theoretical ratio, observed and the theoretical ratio, is due to the error of sampling or by means of due to the chance. मतलब ये जो difference हुआ है between the observed ratio and expected ratio, वो error के कारण हुआ है या फिर it is only a due to the chance. So we have to find out the chi-square of given sample. You will understand this topic by solving one example. So you can say that chi-square is also said to be a non-parametric test. Why it is said to be non-parametric test? Because the value which we used to get is not determined or derived from the observation in the population. So the value whatever we used to get from the calculation is not derived from the observation in the population. That's why it is said to be the non-parametric test. So in examination or in certain papers you can find out which of this is considered to be non-parametric test, which of this type of or statistical aspect is one of the parametric tests. So you have to say that ki chi-square is one of the non-parametric tests. So the formula of the chi-square. So chi-square is written in this way. This is said to be chi-square. So chi-square can be represented by means of this way, or you can say this is nothing but the x-square. So chi-square is equal to very simple formula, summation of observed minus expected divided by expected whole square. So this is a very simple formula of the chi-square test, that is observed value minus expected value divided by expected value the whole square. Sorry, the formula is little bit different. That is chi-square is equal to summation of observed minus expected the whole square. Huh? It's not the whole of E, but only the O minus E divided, it's a whole square divided by the expected ratio. Where O, what is O? You know it is nothing but the observed frequency. Observed frequency. And what is E? E is an expected frequency. Frequency. So the formula is nothing but the summation of observed minus expected the whole square divided by the expected ratio. And it was first used in the testing of statistical hypothesis by Carl Pearson, K-A-R-L, Carl Pearson, in the year 1900. Now, how to calculate the chi-square test? So there are certain working procedure for the determination of chi-square test. The first one is that, what is the working procedure? Working procedure means how to calculate the chi-square test. First, we have to calculate all the expected frequencies, E for all the values. So we have to first calculate the E values, that is expected frequencies. Next point is that we have to take the difference between each observed frequency and the corresponding expected frequency for each value, that is for each value or for each observation, we have to find out a difference between the observed value minus the expected frequency. Next is that the third step in the calculation of the chi-square test is that if we have to make the square of O minus E, because you know the formula is O minus E the whole square divided by E. So this can be achieved by means of squaring this upper number. Next is that divide each square differences by corresponding expected frequency. So we have to divide this by the expected frequency, means after squaring we have to divide it by the expected frequencies of each values, then we'll get the corresponding chi-square of that given observation. And then the last step is that we have to add all the values of number of observation. That is, we have to find out the summation of observed minus expected whole square divided by E. So this is a working procedure of the chi-square test. Means first we have to calculate the E value first. Next is that we have to difference or make a subtraction from the observed ratio. Next we have to make it square. Next we have to divide this square by the expected ratio. And then we have to add all the chi-square of the given. Consider if 5 set of observation is given there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So certain observed value is already given to you. You have to first find out the expected value. First we have to find out the expected value. Then we have to make a difference of observed minus expected. Then we have to make observed minus expected the whole square. And then we have to divide this whole square by E. So in this way we can calculate the chi-square value. Normally the expected value, it is determined from the total size of the sample. So the expected value is determined from the total size of the sample. So if the hypothesis is in the form of 1:1 ratio, agar 1:1 ratio hoga, then the total, jitna bhi total hoga, it should be divided into two equal halves, that is divided by 2. to get an expected ratio. And if the ratio is in the form of, if the hypothesis is 3:1, consider if it is in the ratio 3:1, then we have to divide the total value. Then we have to divide the total by 3/4 and 1/4. That is the two expected ratio. So consider the observed value. If this thing is not, expected value is not there, you have to calculate the expected value. In that case, the given observed value is 37 for the tall one, and the for dwarf one it is given 13. So we know that we have to make it total. So total of tall and dwarf ratio will be the 50. So this is nothing but the total. The totaling of the tall and dwarf both is 50. Now it is in the, according to the hypothesis, it is in the form of 3:1 ratio. If it is in the form of 3:1 ratio, then this should be the 3 and this should be the 1. So we have to tall together, therefore this will be 3+1, that is equal to, it should be divided into 4 parts. But this should be the third part and this should be the one part of it. So we have to divide this 50. We have to divide this, consider if the observed value is of tall is given 37 and dwarf is given how much? 13. So we have to first find out the total. The total we know it is 50. So we have to find out the, this is the third, three part, and this is the one part. It should be in the ratio 3:1. Then what we have to do is that 50 divided by, this will be three part, therefore it should be 3/4. So 50 × 3/4, because this is the third ratio, 3 ratio. If it is first ratio, then it should be 50 × 1/4. So this is the 3 ratio and this is the 1 ratio. So 50 × 3/4, how much it is? 150/4, that will comes around 150/4, 37.5. Similarly, we have to find out, this is the expected ratio. What is this? This is an expected ratio of the tall one. How much we got? We got almost 37.5. So here it should be, what is the expected ratio? Expected to be 37.5. Similarly, we have to find it for dwarf. So we know that for dwarf, how much it is? Totally, that is 50. 50/4, 1/4. 50/1/4, because it is the 1 ratio only. Therefore, 50/4 will gives you the 50/4, that is 12.5. So now we have calculated the expected ratio, 12.5. This is 5, 5. So first, in case of chi-square, we have to find out the observed ratio. Observed ratio already given that. First, we have to find out the expected ratio. So in this way, you have to calculate the expected ratio. Once you have calculated the expected ratio, then we have to put it inside the formula. We know the formula, the first observation, the formula, that is chi-square is equal to observed minus expected by, it's a whole square by E. So what is observed over here? It is 37. So 37 minus, what is expected ratio over here? that is 37.5. So 37 minus 37.5 divided by 37.5. What is expected ratio is 37.5. So in this way we will get the value, and the value that is nothing but the minus 0.5 the whole square divided by 37.5. So the value will be 0.25 divided by 37.5. That is nothing but the 0.006. So this chi square is for the first observation. Similarly, you have to calculate it for the next observation. So for the chi square for the next observation will be again the formula, that is chi square is equal to observed minus expected the whole square divided by expected. We know that for the second observation, what is the observed value? Observed value is 13. 13 minus what is expected value, that is 12.5, divided by expected value, that is 12.5. That is, this is the whole square. So you will get somewhat again 0.5, the whole square divided by 12.5. So that will comes around 0.25 divided by 12.5, that is equal to 0.002. So now we have to add both the, what is the formula, that is chi square is equal to summation of all the chi square of the first observation plus chi square of the second observation, chi square of the third observation, etc., etc. So here we have to find out the chi square, that is summation. What is the first observation? Only two observation is given here. So first one is 0.002